everyone. Today we're going to be unboxing a Good Smile Company Harmonia humming figure doll here. And here we have is 02 from the series Darling in the FranXX. FranXX? However you say that. So here we have is 02 from the series Darling in the FranXX. And released in 2018 from the studio Trigger, A1 Pictures, and Clover Works. And with that anime adaptation, they did release a manga for Darling in the FranXX, but I think we mostly know Darling in the FranXX from its anime adaptation. And also Trigger, if you don't know, also made other animes such as Kill la Kill, BNA, Little Witch Academia, Cyberpunk Edgerunners, and other works, but I don't want to name every single one of them. And along with these, with the Darling in the FranXX, there is two parts and with 24 episodes. And just like all Trigger shows, they're always really good until towards the ending they mess it up. And this is a mecha series and it's actually a really great show. I highly recommend it. And here we can see here we have our Harmony Humming, which is a Good Smile line, which they make him into a cute little peptide little doll for a character in a series. So this is just one of the dolls that they have. And when I saw this, I'm like, it looks really cute. So let me buy it. I have it here now. So as you can see here, this is the box rotating in 360. And the top and the bottom, you'll see shots from there. So without holding you guys back, let's just take her out of the box and see how she looks up close. Alright, taking her out of the box is how she looks when she's packed in her box here. And yes, you do have to assemble this doll. Just like my unboxing of the A-Zone figure, you do have to assemble it together. And she does come with her shirt, which comes in her separate plastic, and also her pants is combined with also her wig or her hair for the doll. Alright, as you can see here, it does come with an assembly instructions guide, but the difference is that this actually comes with an English and a Japanese on the other side. As you can see, I guess they assume that, you know, people from international countries also buy it, so they decided to also give an English. Alright, so here we have is another slip here. You can show that it does have an English and Japanese text, which also you can see if you look closely, that if you do have this close to like any hot areas or humid areas or cold, like I would assume too, they will cause like damage in the clothing and stuff, and it will stain the doll itself. So do be cautious when buying like these types of dolls. And also inside you can see here, you can adjust the eyes and stuff to remove the back of the head. You can position the eyes however you want. Alright, so before we dress her up, this is how the doll looks. Small, peptide, cute. You know, now that I actually look at it, it kind of looks like an alien, right? Well, I mean, 02 is like, can be considered an alien, right? Or is it genetically modified human? I'm gonna be honest, I forgot, but yeah, so let's just continue on here. As you can see, so this is how it'll look if you have her without the clothing and everything. You can see here that there's a line in the back of her head because that's where you remove it, and you can adjust her eyeballs to whatever positions you want. And her eyes also, if you kind of look closely, I know it's kind of hard to tell from my camera, it's almost like a flat, like the eyes are flat, but it's like circular, almost to make it look like have you ever seen a cat's eye? That when you look at a cat's eye, it's like flat, and it's like the eyeball. It's hard to explain, but I think you guys know what I'm trying to say. That's how the eye is, so it's not just like the whole eye is like the color. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is remove her foot, both her foot, I should say, and from then you put on her black pants. And or are they stockings? Well, whatever you call them, you just place them on the doll here and just pull them up, adjust them how I guess you seem fit or how it looks good on the doll. And yeah, afterwards you place the foot back onto the leg. So you put both foot back onto it, and that's how you get the doll. And now that I look at it, when you look at it aside, it's kind of like thick. Alright, so there, here we have her her shirt uniform. That's her, you know, iconic uniform that she has. Do be careful, because the little strap that it has on the assembly instructions does say it's a little fragile. So to avoid damages, try not to like go excessive force all over the shirt itself. To actually place the uniform on, you do have to remove both her arms, and you also have to remove the head. So after you remove all limbs besides the legs and the head, you can just place her into her uniform. Once you place the head right back on it, you'll have the body completed, as you can see here. She does come with a small yellow tie that's like a PVC, so you do place it right in between her collar there. And it was kind of a pain in the ass to put, but just be patient and you'll slip right in. No jokes. And here you can see these are two little white boots, which is like her iconic look. And yeah, they're pretty small. They are hollow from the inside. Just ignore that little speck. That's not part of the boot itself. But yeah, so you don't really need to take anything apart. You can just place them right onto the foot. It should go like all smooth and nice, as you can see here. So all that's left is just to place her hair. So here we have is her little hair, or her wig, I guess, for the doll. And as you can see, you just have to slowly place it on. And I kind of struggled a bit. You squeeze it from the front and you pull back. That's how you place the hair. As you can see, her hair is kind of all messed up, and I guess that's probably why they sell you a comb. So this is her horns that's supposed to be attached to the doll, but you know, since it's a doll, it's separate, so you do have to place it on the head there, and just cover the little clear acrylic from her headgear, but it's actually her horns in the story. And so that's basically the whole Harmonia humming doll. Alright everyone, so this was Good Smile's Harmonia humming's little doll here. I really do like it. It's really cute, especially when you adjust the eyes. As you can see, I actually adjust the eyes a bit to look in the side. It's really cute. The only thing I wish they did was sell her other iconic like uniform, you know, the white one with the, what do you call those hats? I'll put it up in the screen here. They should at least added that too, along with the, as you can see, to fit her whole entire outfit. But regardless, it's still a really cute little figure. And if you're a doll collector, I'm not. I think I only have two, and no, I do have real action. Those are action figures, okay, guys. They're not dolls. The other ones I have, I'm talking about the Metacom toy ones. But anyways, guys, that's gonna be it for me. I'm just gonna let you guys here see the doll rotating 360 with a little bit of close-up shots. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.
Against me.